Among the young people, there is a lack of willingness to join the army, or we do not have that thing for the army. Like, we are, we cannot relate to
you
all.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah, for me, for me. So, you know, can you motivate us for that, sir? Because among the youth, of all I know, we aspire to become doctors or chartered accountants or artists like that. But joining army is not a question that arises in our mind, so...
So, okay, so I would tend to disagree with you. There are a lot of people who want to join the army. That is there, that is true. But I also agree with you that the Indian Army, I don't know how many of you know, is facing a terrible shortage of officers. We don't have a shortage in men. Men we have, but officers, we are facing a terrible shortage. And that's largely true to your point. You may sit down, please. You may sit down.
Yeah.
We are definitely facing a shortage, and that's because a lot of people have started equating material jobs. You know, you make much more money if you go and do an IAM and join a corporate. And yes, you don't join the army for money. But there are three reasons why you should think about joining the army. And I'm not talking about some national patriotic national anthem. That's not the point. The point is, there is no career in this world where you will lead as a 22, 23-year-old captain. You will have 200 men whose lives you will hold in your hands. You can be the president of any place, but you will not be able to take men into battle who will follow you because you are their leader, who lay down their life for you. That's never going to happen. You can pay as much money as you want. You can give. We have to take men into battle without ESOP, pay hikes, employee of the month, or any one of those jamborees. Right? Now, that's a form of leadership which no organization can teach you. No organization can teach you how to take men into certain death with your own personal charisma. That's it. You. That's it. And guess what? I don't know how many of you know this, that in the forces, there is no way I can give a bonus to a soldier who has done exceedingly well or cut the salary. There is no material tool. There is nothing. You have to lead with pure leadership, and no other career can teach you that. Secondly, to give you a little sense about my own career, and I'm just one of them. I'm sure hundreds and hundreds of people like me. I served in the army for about 11 years. Then I moved into the corporate world where I was a CEO for three different companies. And then I moved into the government to raise the national intelligence grid, which was set up after 26/11. And after 5 years, I've now moved back into the corporate. And I can tell you that every lesson, every marketing lesson, every communication lesson that I have ever learned, I learned in the army. We had to learn how to communicate when we were dropping out of aircrafts, where we were parachuting down. We had to know how to communicate with each other. So anything that you need to learn for a business, the root lies in warfare. Because what is business? It is nothing but more contenders contending for less resources. And that is the definition of war. So a lot of us don't realize that the origin of business, origin of communication, origin of logistics, every technology, radar, computers, internet, X-ray, television, sonar, even commercial aircrafts, they all originated from war. So why would you want to learn it secondhand in a B school when you can go to the root and learn it directly from the fountainhead? And I think if you understood that part, my sense is a lot of people will realize that even if you gave 10 years to the army would equip you for a much richer and a much more empowered life. The last piece I want to tell you, and this was a question that was asked earlier also in the panel discussion that we were having. A lot of us assume we are going to live forever. We do. That's why we postpone doing things that we want to do, postpone talking to somebody, postpone writing a mail, postpone karenge baad mein, this, that. That career teaches you why every day is a bonus and why every day has to be lived in technicolor. And that ability to experience life. Think about it. Ask yourself this honest question. That suppose I took your life and filmed it with a 16 millimeter film. You remember the old digital films? Yeah? And I strung it in this hall in a string like this And I took a pair of scissors and started cutting bits and pieces out of it and stuck it back together. You will not even notice the difference. Because one day was like another day was like another day. And so if I took out months and years from your life and you don't notice the difference, you might as well have not lived those years. In that career, you will live every day. Every day that you walk this planet will be a day that you'll experience from the morning till evening as something that you'll nourish. You'll truly live life when you see death.